everyone. It's Tuesday, 9th of August.
Start again.
Ah,
perfect.
Stop it.
Copy perfect.
No, this is my immersion. Don't break my fourth wall.
Okay.
It's Tuesday, 9th of August, and that means only one thing.
Yep.
Stop it, Ed. It's time for the Journey Home and Biscuit Review.
That's with me, Bo. Yeah.
Hi, guys. And, of course, your regular host.
It's me. It is Edward C.
Cutie Pie Lewis.
Thanks very much.
That was horrible. I'm so sorry.
You did a very good job. Round of applause, everyone, for Bo, who did an amazing introduction.
The worst intro ever.
How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, we've actually been talking like for a few hours. So,
I don't know why.
It's just like we just joined in. Hello, everybody. Good to see you. Thank you very much for joining me. We've got Andy FM. We've got Griefed, Academic Dust, 894, Gregor Burns, Horny, Sparrow Black, Captain Fluffy, Andy FM, Sparrow Black, Dante 350, Griefed, Ales Griff. All Woo! Of you. And today, of course, yes, I'm joined again by the brilliant Bo. Thank you so much for joining me today, Bo.
You're very welcome.
Thanks for having me. Did you enjoy the stream last time you were on?
I did.
I'm very sure. yeah, Demon Arrasas, you managed to drag her back on, Ed. How much did that cost you?
To be discussed.
That's to be discussed later on. Okay,
no.
I'm going to jump back on into doing what I do best, and that is playing Elite Dangerous.
We're going into space.
Playing, of course. There's a space game that's on everybody's lips currently. Everyone's playing it. It's all over Twitch.
No way. Elite Dangerous.
Elite Dangerous, of course, is that game. So we're going to be playing that. I'm going to carry on my... apparently, you're the only guest ever to enjoy being a guest on the stream.
Oh.
Yeah.
I highly doubt that.
No, it's fairly true. But... So, Bo, how was your first week? This is your... You were on Tuesday.
Right.
It's Tuesday.
I survived my first week. I'm still here.
What
I'm
did you
still
think?
Alive.
What do you think? Who's your least favourite member of Frontier Developments? Your least favourite. Now, who's your favourite member of the community management team? Remember, it was a
I remember, just like last time, I said all of them, so I think that answer remains unchanged.
Okay. All
Hi,
of them so far.
Commander Kelder.
So today should be another... Obviously, we don't really plan these. We just jump on and see what happens.
See her planning.
We're busy planning what are we doing?
Okay.
If we look really tired,
it's because
can you just take over?
It's because we're working really hard for Gamescom. We're trying to get everything on track. We have to prepare so many different things and make sure everything is working smoothly for you guys. And then in the meantime, obviously, we're also playing the game and chatting with you guys, and it's just a lot.
It's been an interesting first. What's up?
Sorry, what was it? A light was bothering my cheek.
Okay. good. So
yeah, that's why we look like zombies.
But what? So much more professional than me, apparently, according to Andy FM. Right, well, Andy FM, I hope you've got the bar stocked up. What are you serving today? Because, of course, remember, every time we have a frameshift drive failure, Andy FM serves a shot from behind the bar. What is it that you're serving today, Andy FM? Please do let me know in the chat. And also, if anybody has got any further questions for Bo, because she has only been here for... I'm a ghost. Why are we ghosts? Look, we're slightly like ghosts.
Are we?
Look, you can see through us a little bit.
Are we really here? That's
no. That's an obvious answer. No. Not really here at all. So yeah, any more Crystal Skull Vodka? Fantastic, Andy FM.
That sounds great.
I can't say hi on Twitch. So hi from Aladdin Sane. Hi, Aladdin Sane.
Hello, Aladdin.
Aladdin.
What did I say?
Aladdin Sane. No, I think that's the.
Confuse me.
That's the original Bowie pun there for you. So I haven't got any questions because I'm really poorly prepared today.
That's not true. There were questions from last time that you did not ask that we saved. How does your notebook work?
It doesn't.
Jeez.
Keep going. So if anybody please just have any questions.
Yeah, shoot. Or start a conversation, chat. It's fine.
Do whatever you want. You can tell we're enthusiastic today.
I'm really happy to be here.
I'm really happy to be here too. I'm happier to be here than you are.
There's no...
Nope.
How do you organize?
There's no
My OCD brain is
going crazy right now.
It's like none of this makes any sense.
There you go. No, that's not it. Don't read
those. That's not for me.
I almost crashed in.
Bo, what's the meaning of life? Don't ask me that. That scares me. I will think about it and try to come back to you at the end of the live stream when I actually think of an answer.
The live stream, meaning of life.
Oh wow,
that's a good pun. Write
you
that one
down. You must be really tired.
The next time we do that.
Okay. Yes. Questions. Did I like York? I loved York. I've been there before. I was there 5 years ago. Why are you laughing at everything?
No. I'm not laughing. Because you're humorous.
I'm humorous.
Yes.
Okay.
Keep going. Go on.
Do you like Ed? Not at this point. No, I'm just kidding. No. Of course I like Ed. Ed's great. Ed's my hero.
This is good.
It's true.
Keep saying
this. I look up to him with every fiber in my being.
Literally, because I'm like a couple inches taller than you. You have to look slightly up. Which is very rare for me. So that's why I like you, because...
Great.
Yes.
42.
42 is the answer, is the...
Oh, come on. I'm not on it today, guys. Okay.
So, Bo, how was... So what did you think about your first week here on Frontier Developments? What did you think? What were your thoughts going in? Like, now it's been a week. It's a weird one. It's different. Biscuit, you've been 35 minutes. Thank you very much. Griefed.
Thanks, Griefed.
Now that it's been a week, it is different. So you came on, you jumped on the live streams, and you did a really amazing job. I was so pleased that you were just so sort of naturally... good at presenting.
Well, thanks to you guys also on the chat for being so incredibly welcoming, to be honest, because, you know, I've done community management before, and it was kind of a shitstorm being a woman and, you know, being new to the gaming industry and stuff. You got all sorts of things handed to you.
Yeah.
But then here...
Negative things,
yeah. But then here, like, everyone is just so welcoming and so nice and, you know, genuinely interested in who I am, what I want to do and what I want to achieve.
Mm-hmm. Do you mean that internally as well?
And internally as well, exactly. Yeah. Like, I don't think I've ever felt so welcome, you know, starting a new job. Nice. So, yeah, the guys and girls at Frontier are just really... Yeah. They're really lovely. Lovely bunch.
We do. And as Andy FM says, Ed's 38, we look after our own. And you are definitely part of this 38.
Thank you.
Alan says, I can't decide which one of you has better hair. Well, I mean, come on, look at the volume.
We're
of
both
this.
Especially shiny
look,
and green.
Look
today.
How volume. We're a bit green. I'll tell you why.
But mine goes like this. Woo.
Yeah, that's true. And if I try and grow that, it just grows outwards and it grows like to an afro.
It does kind of defy
gravity. And it hasn't even got it's not got anything in it. That's it's the amazing thing about it. Look at that. It's like a sponge.
Wow. It is like a sponge. If we like spill any tea during the biscuit reviews, you know, your hair can just mop it off.
So today I have been joined, of course, by the brilliant Bo, Boa Constrictor.
Wow.
Bo Selector. Bo Selector.
Yeah.
Any others?
Well, last time we had Brobo and Broby-Wan Kenobi.
Broby-Wan Kenobi.
Very much enjoy those.
That's very good. Broby-Wan Kenobi is very good.
Very honourable. I will be there during Gamescom, Miku. So, are you coming? Is anyone in the chat going to be there? Because that would be so cool to meet you guys. If you guys are coming to the Elite Meet as well.
No. This is the frameshift drive thing. It's two in a row.
There we go.
Pour two shots. What are we serving today? Oh, the Crystal Skull Vodka.
Yeah.
As you should always be aware as well, people, please do not actually drink alcohol whilst watching these live streams. It is all just a joke.
All
and you should always be... Yeah.
So, yeah. Did we meet... Third child coming? What? Oh. What should you call your third child?
Ed.
Done. That's it.
You found out right after the tea party. What should you call it? Don't call it Ed. Do not call it Ed. Wait, you should...
Why not?
Just because it's weird, isn't it? Also...
If you're a true fan, you would name your son Ed. Edded. I like to say Edded.
So...
Yeah.
What are you talking about, Ed? I can't drink. No, Demon Aroth, it's worrying, because I think he actually does drink when he watches these streams. Also, do you like our new logo in the top right corner?
Oh, I've seen this. It's so cool.
It's very good, isn't it?
Yeah. It's really, really well done. Oh, there it is. Mm-hmm. Floating into your face.
You can replace people's faces
with it. Wow. Well, better that than my nemesis, Henry.
Henry Cavill.
No, do not dare.
You have like four frameshift drive malfunctions. So basically, in Elite Dangerous, you can get your modules damaged.
Yeah.
Modules are here. It's a very, very complicated game. I'm going to try and teach you as we go through this.
Is that when you pass the planets or their atmospheres? Is that when you repair something, when you pick something up? How does this work again?
So
I tried to listen last time.
A star, you will scoop from those stars
that's
the fuel.
Yes.
And so sometimes if you spend too long scooping from the stars, or if you are me and you're just rubbish at playing the game, and everybody knows this about me, so it's
probably
fine. When you're scooping by it, you can sometimes take too much heat, and that will heat up and give you heat damage to all your ship modules.
Oh, no. Okay.
Yeah, it's very sad.
Okay. Don't do that.
I have damaged my modules, yes.
So, Bo, what games are you most excited for at Gamescom? Ha! Planet Coaster! That's obviously on a professional and a personal level.
Roller Coaster Tycoon World, No Man's Sky. Any others?
I hope Skyrim HD.
Yeah?
I want to see Dishonored 2.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's
and
cool.
Final Fantasy 15.
Mm.
I failed at listening. Stop distracting me, 50 walrus. Yes, those three for sure, and then I'm sure whatever else is there that is moderately exciting.
There's a couple of things that I'm looking forward to. Deus Ex, or is that out already?
2 weeks.
Is that out in 2 weeks time?
2 weeks today, yeah.
So is that before... No, that's when we get back. It's literally when we get back from Gamescom, isn't it?
Okay, so yeah.
Yeah, that'd be good. I'm looking forward to that and the party that we're going to have at Gamescom. Yeah. That's the most exciting thing I'm excited for at Gamescom. Yeah,
be
good. Yeah, so if you are coming along, if you are coming to Gamescom, you should have tickets already been allocated. I don't know if you've been sent an email yet, but I'm pretty sure that we made sure that all of you lot, because as you know, Ed's 38, well, we look after our own. And that means all of you lot have definitely got a ticket.
There.
And you should all be there. And if you're not there, you're going to be thrown out of there forever.
Cool.
That's not true. So, Bo,
that would never happen.
A week in.
Yeah.
Do you think that this is going to last?
Whoa!
Yes.
Finish the question.
Yeah. As in, do you think that you're going to be able to retain the excitement forever at Frontier Developments? And genuinely...
My excitement or their excitement?
Yours.
My excitement, yes. I'm a very excitable person.
Okay, good.
So I'm sure
that
won't be a problem.
Have you... emergency question number
really
one.
Heart attack there.
Emergency question number one. You ready?
Yes.
I'll find them. Watch this.
You find them. It's an empty notebook. Talk about myself.
I've written Ed Lewis down on that page. That's good. That's useful.
Oh.
First emergency question. I'll bring it out of my head hole instead. And that is, have you ever flown a kite?
Stop. Okay, actually, let me tell you what happened after the last live stream.
Yeah.
So, thank God. I send it to my dad being, you know, I was a little bit proud because it was my first one. And I was like, Dad, please watch me, like, you know, talk to Ed.
Yeah.
And he's like, he replied with a one-lined email saying, don't know what you're talking about, but I'm very sad you don't remember us flying a kite together on the beach. So I broke my dad's heart. really sad.
So now he's going to take you out flying a kite.
I'm pretty sure he's sending me a kite.
The answer is yes, you have flown a kite.
I have flown a kite. I literally do not remember, but I feel really bad about it.
So. Emergency question number two.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen a ghost?
Like how you are right now.
Yeah, not like that, like a real spooky one.
I don't really believe in ghosts.
Doesn't mean you haven't seen one though, does it?
Exactly. Like I would never take away from anyone's, you know, paranormal experiences.
So you don't have any ghost stories?
I don't personally have ghost stories, no.
Okay, well, I've got a ghost story. Would you like to hear my
ghost
story?
Literally holding onto the table now.
Would you like to hear my ghost story?
I would love to hear your ghost story. Go.
I need some spooky music. Hold on, let's find some spooky music.
Shall I fly your spaceship in the meantime?
No!
Rule number one, do not.
Rule number one, never touch my spacecraft.
Bloody touch it.
Scary music. Searching
Excuse
for
me
YouTube.
For coughing.
Here we go. We've done this before, it didn't work.
see if this works now. Oh no, did it have to be a clown? Oh my god.
Shit.
Stop. I don't like clowns, people. Is it gone? Is it gone? Are you really? Is it gone?
It's gone, but the music is.
Thank you. Stop. Oh, Lord. Okay.
Would you like to fly the ship? People seem to want to let you fly the ship.
I am not taking this responsibility. Oh my god.
It's hiding away from
you. So, that's too scary.
Maybe when we
I won't know what I'm doing.
Maybe when we touch back down in the.
In an environment where I cannot hurt Ed's ship or his progress.
This is the ghost story.
Yes.
The ghost story is that you played Elite Dangerous and crashed the ship, and forever there was a ghost of the ship, forever, and that was it.
His worst nightmare.
So.
Yes, go.
I had a. My dad.
We're so serious today.
My dad got married. And when he was getting married at a castle in Scotland.
Yeah.
Really spooky old castle. My sister had to stay in a room with my girlfriend at the time because we were young. We were 16 and 17. And my dad was a traditional man. This is scary, isn't it? Got married. Whoa! A lifetime of being together.
It's not scary.
It's, commitment! So, then...
Yes.
I do have a selection of music for every story. Thank you for the story, 50 Walrus. Yes, no, and then we were in a castle, and then my sister, she had to stay in the room with my girlfriend at the time. And then, I know... Yeah, he'd want to stay in a room with her.
Oh.
She was terrible. My sister and my girlfriend, like, you take your pick. They're both fine.
They're both fine.
Yeah. Then, at night, my ex-girlfriend at the time, heard some strange noises. And she awoke to see my sister sitting up in bed.
Oh, God.
Go it. Do it, and I'll do an impression of what my sister did. She went. This is true. And then Jill, who was my ex-girlfriend at the time, I'm getting goosebumps. This is how scary this story is. Jill at the time, she was standing at the window, and then there was a woman, a silhouette, standing in the window, who was looking at my sister. And they were communicating, and she was communicating to her in tongues like that. So, when in the morning,
Griefed, I hope you're on.
In the morning, Jill was like, "What the hell was that, Maddie?" And then Maddie was like, although they didn't really communicate much because Jill was...
She was still talking in tongues.
Well, she was just afraid of my being confident around my family, which... And then, the next morning, they went and we did a tour of the castle. And the tour lady went, "Who's staying in this room?" And the lady, this is true. And Maddie didn't know about this before. And neither did Jill. She said, "Actually, this room's famous because the woman who lived in here used to own the castle,
mm-hmm.
and she died in that room, and she can still be seen. Apparently, it's supposed to be the most haunted room of the castle. She can still be seen stalking throughout the grounds." That is
proper horror.
Is
Stop
my,
with the clown!
That's
oh
my ghost
no.
story. And then a big clown jumped in, and it was like, the clown! They're meant for your attention.
The whole,
there you go.
Like, the ghost story.
Look, why is Ed telling stories that should be scary?
Thanks, Orange.
That's
Park.
It. There you go.
I didn't know what to do
that's
with my face.
That's my ghost story. So question:
yeah.
Have you ever seen a ghost? Have you ever seen a ghost?
He keeps popping up this clown picture. It really.
It's gone now. It's
really
gone forever.
Disturbing.
It's gone forever. I will never bring it back up.
Don't you dare.
And now I know.
Sincerely,
how
do
to,
not like.
Now
clowns.
I know how to get Beau easy.
No!
Yeah.
No, I will cry.
Okay. So, We would never want that. All right, Bo.
Shaking. Yes. Back to normal.
The clowns have gone. Have you ever seen a Bigfoot? Yeah.
Here.
No, just.
What?
Oh. Yeah, that's what I said.
No. No.
You've seen a Bigfoot? You've never seen a Bigfoot?
No, I have not seen a Bigfoot, okay. No.
What do you seriously think that Bigfoots are then?
What?
So you know big.
No, I know. Yeah. I'm just, I don't know.
My
how
question
to
is
to you right
simple.
Now.
The question is simple. What do you think that when people see big feet, foots, what's the plural of big foot? Big feet. When people see big feet, mm-hmm, what do you think
what's
that
going on
what
today,
is what are they
seriously
seeing? This is my emergency question list.
This is not your emergency questions. Big foots are hobbits.
No.
That's what Horny says.
Horny is incorrect. Bigfoot. What do you think they are? Do you think they're just bears? Do you think people are just mistaking them when they see them out in the countryside? Do you think it's all just a hoax? What do you think the big feet are?
I don't know. I'm okay. Sure there's a Bigfoot somewhere.
I'm sorry. You sure there is a Bigfoot
really
somewhere?
Really throwing me off.
Sorry. Anybody got any normal? Oh, Grief's got a ghost story. When I was a little kid, I had to climb a ladder to get into the bedroom. You could look into a small corridor on the ladder. One night when I climbed the ladder, I saw a black figure rushing towards me in the corridor. You never managed to climb a ladder faster in your life. Probably still
that's wet. True. I mean, that happens sometimes when you're
20 minutes, thank
walking
you
somewhere, you're going somewhere in the dark and or there's darkness behind you. Mm-hmm. And you have this feeling that like you have to run, like,
yeah,
you know?
That's not
like when I was the last one to close that, the yeah lights or whatever. Mm-hmm.
That's not ghosts, though.
Turn off the light. No, but it's just this
it's
haunting,
a creepy feeling.
Creepy feeling that, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, what did you study at university, though?
I studied psychology for my bachelor's degree, media psychology and child psychology.
Very cool.
And lifespan psychology.
Everybody, cue jokes in the chat about how child psychology and me, and you, that's why you're able to communicate with me because you study child psychology. That's what
well, yeah, and vice versa, so, you
yeah,
know,
yeah, well,
that's why.
It's fine, it's going to work. Look, see, look, I'm a ghost.
Anyways, yeah, and then I did a minor in performing arts.
Oh, yeah.
Jazz hands. That was terrible, sorry.
Have
sorry
you
about
that. You found anywhere in Cambridge yet that will?
Not yet, but to be honest, I've been so
been
busy and tired that I have not really been actively looking. But yeah,
No,
psychology.
You were doing very well.
And then as for my master's degree, I came to the UK and I studied journalism.
So did I.
I know.
Funnily enough, that is exactly what I did too. And they
literal
know that.
Twins. Three,
nearly. Two, one. Same colour hair. We've both got faces. We've both got legs and arms.
Yeah, that's true. Mm-hmm.
We'll leave it there. Similarities, but we're different in some ways too. We won't go into those differences right now.
Wow. So where are we?
Where are we? We're in space.
We're still in space.
So would you like to see where we are? Let's have a
yeah,
look.
So let's have a look.
We, on Saturday, we did the Sagittarius A tea party.
Journalism isn't a proper degree.
She's the second new community content manager. The guest is Bo. So who's the guest as Yuri Gosanovsky? It's Bo. Bo Marit de Vries. Yes. Full name Bo Marit.
Yes.
But you prefer to just go by Bo.
Just go by Bo. It's more fun.
But you are Bo Marit on Twitter, which is a confusing message if you ask me.
No, it's not. Literally the only person who it confuses is you.
Is it me?
The only person who's not able to ever
so it's like everybody calling me if you called me Edward C. Lewis constantly, just because that's my Twitter name.
Exactly.
Okay, great.
I think you're there.
Yeah, Orange Spark has got legs too. Osric's got a scary story. I was walking through a graveyard many, many years ago with my girlfriend at the time. Mm-hmm. It got very cold and she gripped my hand very tightly. You looked over your shoulder and standing on a grave was a figure of a man wearing... didn't do that. A man wearing blue trousers and a brown jacket, but where his face should be, it was just black.
Like a black figure or a headless figure?
I don't know.
Ooh, spooky.
Is that real, Osric? Or are you just...
I believe you, Osric.
I don't believe you, Osric.
Come on. You can't, like, mm-hmm, nullify other people's experiences with
no,
ghosts.
I don't believe in ghosts either. Although
yeah,
I did have
same,
one...
Same.
There was one night where we stayed in an old mill in... No, seriously.
Sorry.
Not you. Me and my family stayed in an old mill in Oxfordshire.
Yeah. And very pretty.
Yeah, it's very nice, yeah. And we stayed there in the mill, and it was... what am I saying again? Oh, yeah.
Your ghost story.
My ghost.
Poor Ed. Guys, everyone just pity Ed for a second. Just 30 seconds, give him some pity.
I don't need your pity.
He really does. He needs hugs.
Yeah.
He's very he's very busy and very tired.
Freaked out. Freaked out. It's real. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. No,
let's you've all care
yeah.
for Ed.
Well, yeah.
You know.
Let's do that. You can't nullify
Work
other people's experience. We always pity Ed. No pity from Demon of Wrath. He doesn't want my pity. Captain Fluffy, I have my pity. I don't need your pity. I've said this before.
Don't be, you know, ungrateful.
I'm
be
not
nice.
Ungrateful. Sorry.
They're supporting you. It's mm-hmm. good. It's very good. I like this community.
Do you have any questions for me, though? That I didn't tell... I told you not
yes,
to prepare
Ed.
Anything. Okay.
What is your favourite video game ever? Did I ask?
Good question.
Ask
no,
you
didn't
time.
Ask me last time, no. My favourite video game ever... it's very difficult. It's a very difficult question. Elite Dangerous, of course, is my favourite video game ever.
Mine too.
And Planet Coaster is my second favourite video game mm-hmm. ever.
The immersion is real.
What else did we have? We
you
have,
never leave the office.
Andy FM's got another scary story. Would you like to read Andy FM's scary story?
Yeah. Stop.
That's very nice.
I always start laughing. It's not fair. At my grandparents' house, my mom got up in the middle of the night and heard monks singing.
Mm.
In the morning, she told my gran, and she said that there used to be a monastery where the house is built. Dun, dun, dun.
Probably just a monk, wasn't it? How do you know it was a monk and not just somebody singing? What differentiates it a monk? She just thought it was a monk. Probably wasn't a monk. So, my favourite game, now that I've delayed it long
maybe
enough.
Maybe it was
grand. So I've got a few... D. Monoroth says, if you say Zelda, you'll send me some beers. Zelda, oh. then, yeah. Zelda, that's it. Now, I really like... the Metal Gear Solid series. That sounds like a crazy person thing to say, I know, but I really, really like Metal Gear Solid. I like the Final Fantasy series, but mm-hmm. For me, it was Final Fantasy VII that actually made me start writing short stories and things because I would like copy the characters and write little short stories based around Final Fantasy VII. So it was one of the first times that I got really
immersed into a game
and
story.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Immersed. Well, it. Yeah, immersed into something that I thought, like, I was captured by it so much that I was like, I want to write things that are similar to this.
Yeah, exactly.
So that was cool. Like, it was the first time I was, like, experimenting with, like, writing and being creative myself as well.
Cool.
So, yeah, I like that. And then what else did I do? I like Final Fantasy X is really good. We were talking about Final Fantasy X the other day.
Yeah,
obviously
yeah,
awesome.
Yeah. That's fine.
And then, yeah, things like that. Eddie, looking forward to The Last Guardian. Yes, really much, very, very much so. I really like The Shadow of the Colossus. I didn't play Eco, but... I've heard of really good things. Have you played Shadow of the Colossus?
I have to.
Have you played it? You haven't played it?
I have not, but okay. It's been given to me and I must play it.
Yeah, you should. It's really good.
Yes, I shall.
Gregor Burns asks, what's your opinion of Atari? What Gregor Burns by that means is Atari published Roller Coaster Tycoon World. And yeah, so you might want to avoid answering that. So I don't know, I just asked you.
So at this point in time, I cannot answer your questions.
Very
Gregor
good,
Burns.
Look at that. Very good.
However, if you ask me something else, I will try my very best to answer that question.
Okay.
Ah, wow.
Good stuff. This is so you know how last week's was really good?
Yeah.
This has been... As in, like, not, that's not you.
So this
not,
week.
No, that's not.
We are so dead that literally, it's so.
It's my fault.
No, it's okay.
This is how most of
We're
the streams
fine.
Go every day.
No.
It is.
Okay, so Ed.
Yeah, go on.
Let's talk TV shows.
Yeah, go for it.
What is your all-time favorite
TV
or top
show.
Three TV show? Yeah.
Breaking Bad is in there.
Very good.
I really like Breaking
agree with
Bad.
That.
I really like.
Thanks, Osric.
What did Osric say?
He said it was a very good PR response.
FSD malfunction, if you could please pause shot number 4 or 5 of the day. At this point, and remember, yeah, our streams are weird. These streams are very strange, but... it was a bit more sort of like...
Nonetheless.
Yeah, so what else do we have? What else do I like?
Have you ever watched Lost?
Game of Thrones? I love Lost. I love Game of Thrones. Game of Thrones, I've read the books. Have you read the books?
I've read the books.
So
I love the books.
I read the books first.
I read the books first too, yeah. Mm-hmm. Actually, I saw the first episode.
And then,
I was like, this is so up my alley. I need to watch, or I need to read the books before I watch the rest of this because, yeah. So I watched it and I read the first book, I think, in a week or something.
Okay.
And I was just like, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great show.
Mm-hmm. No, it is really good. And as we all know.
Would you like to?
No.
Okay. Ed does a great Jon Snow impression. Wow, throwing you under the bus.
Believe me, they've heard it.
Have they really? Okay.
Yeah, they can't. It doesn't take long.
I'm very impressed.
Yeah, for people to get past all. Best film ever, Beau. Go. Emergency question. Thank you very much, Captain Fluffy, for emergency question.
Lord of the Rings.
Alan Partridge. That's my favourite TV show ever.
Alan Partridge.
Have you ever watched Alan Partridge before?
I have not.
Escapes. No, Alan Partridge is a British comedy.
Yeah, okay.
Have you ever seen a ghost? No, that's not a ghost. Have you ever seen The Office?
Yes!
The UK Office.
I've seen both.
What do you think of the...
I love David Brent. I love David Brent. It sometimes reminds me of David Brent.
What? You've made me... very happy. He is who I aspire to be. Aha!
Yeah.
Steve Coogan.
Steve Coogan.
Alan Partridge.
Yes.
Biscuit review in 10 minutes.
Thanks, Griefed. I need some Partridge education. Apparently.
Yeah, you do. No, yeah. we
I need lots of education
Partridge.
Ever since I moved to the UK.
So what do you think of the UK? So what do you think of the United Kingdom? So what is first of all, what is your experience of being here? Like, how long have you been here for before this?
I was here for a year,
but you were here. What were you doing here for that year?
That's when I did my master's.
Ah,
I studied
In Newcastle.
Newcastle. Don't ask me to do a Geordie accent because I cannot.
Sure, I won't.
I don't know how to do that. I could barely understand my landlord. But I really liked it there. I mean, people were very in your face, but in a funny way. Like not in a it bothers me kind of way. They're just very, you know, living their life and doing their thing, and I like that mindset, so yeah, I enjoyed it there.
Yeah, it is good, and I think that the north of England has that sort of stuff generally.
Yeah,
that's where
they're
I'm
very
from,
chill.
The north, but the west side of things. Have you ever visited Blackpool?
I have not.
Good.
That's what I was
actually
told.
that's offensive because I think there are some people in the chat that actually live in Blackpool. It's really lovely, it's just not
okay. Cool.
Yeah.
It's your favorite movie of all time.
My favorite movie of all time. This is of all time. This is a hard question.
It's so hard to answer.
I can tell you what one of my favorite series of all time. One of my favorite directors is Richard Linklater.
Mm-hmm.
He did a series called Sunrise, Sunset. Sunrise series is what I called it.
Okay.
Before Sunrise, Before Sunset, and Before Midnight. And the film's just about dialogue, essentially. And it's Ethan Hawke and a nice lady that I can't remember her name. And they meet on a train. Go, quick, Google that. they meet on a train, and then they just get off the train and just go, get off the train with me. And then they get off the train, and they just talk all day. And then she leaves at the end. And then they don't know what happens. But then, 10 years later, real time, as in, so the film ends there, the first film. 10 years later, the director, same cast, same director, films the second film, and it picks up 10 years later.
Oh, cool.
And so it's about, like, what happened between that time.
And how,
they just talk about it, but it's so smartly done. And then they did it again, 8 years later, Before Midnight, and the same thing again, but they're together. I don't want to spoil anything.
It's
really depressing, but it's brilliant.
Oh,
I like depressing things.
Okay.
I really like depressing things. Everybody, I like depressing things, such as this live stream, which is the most depressing thing in the world. It's not really. I love you all so, so much. It is dead good to have you all here.
You have to keep your spirits up today.
Quick, I do. Come on. Shake some maracas.
Woo, yeah. Give me one. Woo. Oh, that's really loud.
No, I'm joking. Come on, let's keep going. So we've got a few more minutes until today's biscuit review. No, it's not. It's,
you got it, Ed.
You just need to.
You got this.
You've come in here.
I know.
Beau, and you. No, I do. Spoonful. I wholeheartedly adore you all. yeah, my ears. Sorry, Tom Parks. I do apologise.
That's really loud.
No, it's just, it's one of those things, is they see me every single day. So there's going to be ups and there's going to be downs, right?
This is not one of
this
them.
This is a massive, huge up. But you've come in here, seriously, you've come into the community management team and it's been brilliant. And I genuinely want to say a huge thank you for you to join. Like, I'm really glad it's been, you interviewed 3 months ago.
Yes.
And I was actually really looking forward to you starting as well. Like, it was such a long time ago. I was like, come on, like, when is Bo starting? So I'm really glad that you're here.
Get over here.
It's really good. Yes.
Thank
Hurry
you.
Up.
Thanks. I mean, see, this is what I mean. Like, everyone is just so nice.
Yeah.
And Ed is just, all he's doing is making me laugh all day.
And as Greg, and as Gregor Byrne says,
good
laugh
and bad.
Laugh at me, not with me. As Gregor Byrne says, actually, Ed, this live stream is helping to cure my real life depression, gives me something to look forward to every day.
Oh.
So, like, I have received a few, and we haven't been too weird. Yeah, exactly. Everyone's been so nice to you.
I know.
Which is really, really surprising. That's not.
Well, you can get weird, too. I mean, I'm sure I get weird at some point.
Yeah.
You know, mm-hmm. right there on Ed's level. Mm-hmm.
Biffa 2001 says, we try not to be too weird. Bo, what are your favourite Dutch snacks?
Ooh.
More emergency questions, please.
Ooh.
Okay.
Obviously, I love licorice. Licorice? Is that how you say it? Licorice. I know. I'm.
You love licorice?
Yeah, but
nobody likes licorice.
All Dutch people do, though, and it's like, it's funny because all the people that are not Dutch that I ask don't necessarily enjoy it as much as I do. It's really good.
Yeah.
And stroopwafels.
Stroopwafels. Stroopwafels. Is that right?
Stroopwafels.
Wafels.
That's very good.
Learning Dutch with Ed.
Actually, I should bring some for your biscuit review because they're like waffles mm-hmm. with caramel in between them.
Mm-hmm. I think we've not done.
They
on the
sell them
that I
here.
Before, yeah.
They sell them here in the UK, but it's not the real ones. They're not.
No. Stuperiffles is better 2001. Not quite.
Yeah, they're good. They're really good. Yeah.
Cool. So they're your favourite Dutch snacks.
If I must.
People are just still
pick
talking.
A snack, then yeah.
But what is your necklace?
Phonetically writing. Oh, my necklace. This is a Christmas gift.
Oh,
by
nice.
My boyfriend that I really love to wear and don't ever take it off. Yeah, it's a circle with little circles inside.
Nice.
It's very
nice.
Special to me. Thank you. What is the last music gig I went to, Osric? Wow, it's been a long, long time since I went to a gig. Let me think. I have to think about that one. I'm sorry. Wow.
Everyone just wants strip waffles now.
Everyone wants stroopwafels. I'll bring them. I'll import them. I'll ask my dad to send them along with a kite.
The kite is now just going to get referenced every single
time. And croquettes, of course. Croquettes.
What are croquettes?
Wow. So
no,
do you know
I
snack
know
walls
think,
in Holland?
Snack walls.
Snack walls. It's literally like when you go to snack bars, they have like a literal wall, and inside the wall are little windows, and inside
in
those little windows are snacks for you, like fried
and
things.
That's a thing that exists generally.
This explanation is terrible. But
3 minutes until the biscuit. What do you mean?
That was fast.
Yeah. What do you mean? I saw those amazing ghost stories that have kept
time,
going.
Time flies
going.
When you're talking about ghosts.
Nonsense. Go on. What are you saying?
Henry Cavill.
It's his fault. Let's bring him on.
No! Do not! I was cursing!
Oh, Stephen Crabb. That's Psycho Cow.
I'm trying to think in my head what is worse, clowns or Henry Cavill? No, clowns are worse. Clowns are worse. But Henry Cavill just makes me aggressive.
You'll be happy to know that he's gone.
Thank you.
Like,
great. Yeah, Fabo. There we go. It's just, you know, you put a euro into the wall and out comes your fried snack. It's literally a wall.
Okay, so it's like a little, you have a little.
A wall, like the wall of a house.
The wall, like a big tall sheet of ice.
A wall.
The wall.
The big, wall.
The north. In
the
north.
Wall. The wall in the north.
Right,
in the north.
Henry Cavill with clown makeup.
No! Who said that? Andy FM. Pour me some more vodka because that's not going to work for me.
Can you please swear in Dutch? Coots is not here.
Godverdomme!
Oh.
Yeah. Sorry, that was really loud. That just means, goddammit. Okay.
Do another one.
They're really good when you're stoned.
Because it is legal in Holland. You can say that, yeah.
Yeah, it is legal. Yay for drugs.
And if M pulls Bo a large vodka. Did you say yay for drugs?
Like, I just assume that's how they're all feeling right now about Holland.
Yeah. So
no,
tell,
yay
me, about,
for
tell
drugs,
me about that.
People.
No,
don't
all,
like
in
drugs.
All, in all seriousness.
Yeah.
What are your experiences? No, don't. What do you think about people who only come over to Holland for that specific reason?
They're more than welcome to, obviously. I would say educate yourself before you do anything, but mm-hmm. that's even if you're Dutch. Don't be an idiot.
What's Basel?
Whatever country you're in. What?
Surely you're not afraid of Basel.
There's this old duo,
Dutch
TV show. Mm-hmm. I'm so bad at explaining things. It's a clown and an acrobat. it's like child sentiment, really.
Okay. Child sentiment.
And he asks, Grieft asks, am I scared of the clown? And the answer is,
yes.
Not scared.
Terrified.
But I really don't like it.
Which clown?
Slightly scared. Bussy is the clown.
Okay.
So yeah, as much as you need to educate me on the Alan Partridge
yes.
show,
oh my God.
And other UK amazingness, I will educate you.
Do you like
Thomas Rommels? They owned it.
Do you? It's gone up.
It was like our Inspector Gadget, but in Dutch.
So it's just right.
Beyhundert, B100, he's called.
One thing that's
he had a phone. It came out of his shoulder.
So Dutch.
So
the most
cool.
Dutch thing I've ever heard. I watched some Dutch ladies last night throwing themselves around in an arena.
Right.
All wearing little shorts.
Are we talking about the Olympics now?
Are you talking about the Olympics?
Okay, yeah.
No, imagine. No. It's just why
just I do went to
my,
an arena
just
and
what
watched
I do my spare
that.
Time.
Yeah, okay.
And they were all brilliant. And it was the volleyball.
Right. We have some amazing athletes in our country.
We were cheering for the Dutch because they were against the Americans. The Americans
as
won
you
in the
should.
End. It was very disappointing. Anyway, yes. Grief has let us know, just as we're getting into Australia things and just as I'm sort of waking up and actually snapping out of my Mr. Negative attitude, which I do apologise for.
That's right. I'm trying to overcompensate. I'm sure it's not coming across at all.
You've done brilliantly.
Gregor Burns, I'm not afraid of snakes and I'm a tiny little bit afraid of spiders, but I'm living on my own has been, you know.
Oh, really?
Helping me get over that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm now very good with a vacuum cleaner. My personal Henry.
I got quite good at it recently because there's some just massive ones in the bath and you're just like, well.
I just don't like the jump scares they give you, really.
Well, the first time you see
them.
Like,
you turn around and you're like, where did you come from?
But they're all right. I don't mind them as long as they're not crawling on my face or on me. Bye-bye, Yuri. Thank you very much for seeing us. So.
Can't be bothered with Biscuits today.
What?
Wow, Yuri. That's the best part, isn't it?
In it. Ladies and gentlemen.
See you.
Would you like to read the...
Oh!
Yeah, would you like to read?
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
Gents, sorry. Yes. Gents. It's time for the... Quietly.
Yeah, not too loud.
Biscuit review!
Yes.
Woo! Get yourself a cup of coffee.
Mm-hmm.
Tea.
Tea.
And make yourself very comfortable.
You added a very in there.
And a round of applause for Ed for being amazing.
A round of applause for Bo. She's a great addition for the show. Thank you, Grieft. Wonderful stuff.
Slow clap.
All right, yeah, no, it is time for the biscuit review. Everybody knows what happens here. We are going to have Don't go away. Don't go away.
Please don't. Please
just
don't
go. Just leave.
Stay.
Stay forever,
stay
please. So I'm going to go.
Stay for Ed. He needs it today.
I do need it. I need that. I need that boost, that little just this little,
the boost.
The boost. The boost. No, actually that. I'm gonna do the thing I usually do, which
yes.
is sorry, let's start again. Entirely. You ready?
You got this.
Hey everybody and welcome back to the live stream. It's Edward Lewis
Hi.
Here. I am super professional, very cheery, and nothing can get me down today. It's fantastic. So, Bo's here and I'm here, but we're actually gonna go just for one moment now to go grab
just
a fresh cup of tea.
Yes.
Oh, Yorkshire tea. It's the only
Yorkshire
tea for me, and by association, it's the only tea for Bo. Then
Right.
we're gonna go away. We're gonna walk over into that kitchen. Oh no, we're gonna do that first. We're going to go to the kitchen first. We're going to get a cup of tea. We're going to bring that cup of tea back here. And then we've got today's biscuit review. So you know how this works. Look after each other. Be nice and kind to one another. Be excellent to each other. Give each other a little tickle and a little hug. Listen to some nice elevator music. A tickle. Do you know what a tickle is? Is
that I know what a tickle is, yes.
Just don't do that. Only appropriate tickles only.
There we go.
All right.
And no, tickles.
We'll be back in a second.
Bye.
2 minutes. Time is it?
It is
roughly 8 minutes two-ish, and that means
hi, friends.
Time for the biscuit review with me and your other guest host.
Me.
This one.
Me.
Yes, Bo DeVries. Okay, Bo. So
we
you know how
tea.
This works now. You were here last time.
I am a pro.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Fuel Rats mug, very nice. That's a dangerous related thing. I'll tell you about that later.
I knew that. I so knew that.
Okay, great.
Yum, biscuits. Okay.
So everybody, how is everyone going? We need an update on that picture. Bo isn't that white under the nose.
Excuse
okay.
me?
Okay, on this picture, they're saying that, I think they're saying that that's you.
But I am as cute as a little polar bear.
Yeah. Sure. If you say so yourself.
I said so myself.
Right, so let's have a look here. So the other day, on Saturday, we had the Fortnum and Mason strawberry and cream afternoon tea biscuit. You just tasted one of those yourself earlier. What did you think of it?
Wow.
Yeah?
I heard the stories first. Ed came in on Monday and was like, oh, hallelujah. And was very excited.
Yeah.
And I just had the pleasure of trying one.
Yeah.
And my oh my. Are they amazing?
They're very, very good.
They're
yeah.
really
so
good.
I understand just wanted why. To, I wanted to make sure that it wasn't just me doing, getting overly excited about something that was just because it was a good day. It was
my birthday.
The sun was out. I was thinking the whole time, like, well, it's Pat's birthday.
Had my tea party. Yeah, sure.
It's very good.
Aw, nice day there, yeah.
So all the way down here at the bottom we have the Kent and Fraser friggin' hazelnut crunchy chucky crunchy cookies gluten free. So today's biscuit, and of course sent in from the wonderful Commander Niku,
is the
Sablé de Moissons. I think that's how you pronounce that.
Le Sablé de Moissons.
Moissons, very good.
And that's about
us. Traditionnel chocolat au lait. So
very
chocolate
nice.
Milk
chocolate.
And traditional cereals.
Traditional cookies.
No idea what these are, but as we know, of course, in this game, we've not
no biscuit cam today.
No biscuit cam today, even though the word biscuit cam is in the corner there still. Goodbye. Biscuit cam. It's just...
Just spill on my forehead, really. There we go.
There you go.
Lovely.
Biscuit cam on your face.
Oh.
It's gone. Okay, so as we know, there's no... There's no points for packaging.
Nope.
We go straight on to appearance for the actual biscuit. I need to, if you just hold this for 1 second and read, so that's... it's very good. Le sable de moisson. Thank you, Beau. That's fine, that'll do.
You got it.
Okay, so if you, do the honours. Do you want to get things open? I think there's like a little tab thing on the other side.
Woot woot! Bam! Mm-hmm. Isn't that like one of the most satisfying things to do? Like these rip thingies and you rip them off like when you get mail and... I'm sorry. Yeah. Wow, look at that.
Okay, yeah, look good.
Look at that.
Getting excited already.
It's beautiful.
So Daryl Sheets says, where's Chad? Get Chad on. That's somebody who... We'll get Chad on. You know what? I'll get Chad on tomorrow. We'll get Chad on for guest Wednesdays. There you go,
beard.
How about that? Chad has a big beard.
Oi, mate. That was as far as it goes. Sorry,
no,
chat.
I liked it.
There we go.
Okay.
So, get the first one.
Thank you very much.
You're
it's
the,
very kind
you're the
of
original
you.
Biscuit master.
I can't. This is they're stuck together.
I know. Last time I was here,
really? Right.
Okay. They're like all
like actually quite.
They're quite sticky.
It's a disaster.
Oh no. Okay, there's cookie crumbs everywhere.
Yeah,
Henry is going to have a blast. It's really not working for us today, is it, guys?
So
this is...
No, this
there
is
we
this
go.
Is working.
Oh, this, this is working.
This is
so
what
this
is supposed
what
to happen.
This is one. One survived. So, I'll just show you.
Oh, you don't.
No one took a bite. It's just it broke.
No.
It's already melting in my fingers.
It's horrible.
So, excuse me very much.
Yeah. Is it
but it's pretty. It's like it has a cute little shape.
Yeah, no, it is. And there's one here as well, which you can see.
This is Ed's remnant.
Yeah, and you can see here as well that's another one. It's been defaced. You would say
yes.
The word defaced. But, so what would you say in terms of a
Niku?
Yeah,
what have you done?
It's disgusting. Thanks, Niku.
Okay.
Cheers, mate. It's just a live stream now of two people. Making horrible...
Making really bad noises.
Like a disgusting mess. Okay, so,
yeah.
Appearance. What do you think, what would you rate the appearance of this biscuit?
It has a cutesy shape.
Mm-hmm.
And I like that there's relatively a lot of chocolate on
relatively
there.
Relatively a lot. I'm so sorry about this.
It's beautiful. It's all right. However, this... Does that count for appearance? Because this is like the first thing I'm encountering.
That's your appearance. And today we aren't reviewing you.
Well.
Because I'm sure you'd make it all the way to the top of the list.
Ever. No. I have chocolate on my forearm. No, this is my tattoo.
Great.
No, really. That's my tattoo. The rest is freckles. So. Appearance, I would say 6.5.
Good choice.
Yeah.
Very good choice.
Yeah.
I like it. I think it looks nice. I like the frills around
Henry
the edges.
The Hover is here.
I like the chocolate. Where is he? Oh, he's in. Hey, Henry
the Hover.
Did someone mention crumbs? Yes, we did. Taste. All right, go for it. I hope you don't mind. I literally had to grab it
It's okay.
Go for it.
No cooties.
You ready?
So, yeah.
Mmm.
Oh.
Mmm. Mmm.
Very tasty.
Mmm.
Oh, it's very crumbly.
Yeah, very, I mean...
Very crumbly.
I look like I've had an accident.
Lean forward a bit.
So, look at this.
Ooh.
It's horrible.
Ed is making such a mess. I'm doing pretty well.
Yeah.
However, yeah, except for my fingers,
this
really.
Is bad news. Bad news all around.
Yeah.
Oh, but they're... Having a horrible time.
The chocolate is really good.
Somehow, yeah. Okay.
Biased towards chocolate, though.
So what do you think? I think I'm going to say we're going to do it together on the taste.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's okay, and then the cereal's quite thick.
Yeah.
So like, but the chocolate's good.
7.
I was going to say 7. Mm. I was genuinely going to say 7. Yeah. We're in perfect agreement. Texture. I think that there's a nice.
It's quite thick. Like it's a thick. It's quite. Mm-hmm. Right, there we go. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's very cereally, and that's quite...
Very cereally.
It's enjoyable.
And I like cereal, but I like it with a good load of milk. It's really, like, I'm...
It's so messy here,
so
you don't want to know.
No, more ways than one. So, texture?
7?
No.
7? Higher?
No.
No? 6?
6.7.
6.7, yeah.
Durability, so...
Well,
4.
It's falling apart.
It's not, though. Did it fall apart when you bit it? No. It was just the
Falls
initial...
Apart in my mouth.
Like, it was the initial
yum,
sticking
yum, yum.
Together, but then why was it frozen? It hasn't been in this room this entire time, so I'm a bit confused about this.
It's been in his back pocket.
It's got to be
just kidding.
Just... 54 is what I've gone for.
That's great. 54
no, that's
sounds
too high.
Good.
Dunkability!
My
right.
fingers aren't ready for this test.
Do you want me? Do you want? I can just.
Oh,
we can do a
I
solo
made my
dunk.
Mug so dirty.
We can,
no, I'm no.
This
commitment, man.
Look, all right, you ready?
Oh shit! Yeah, sorry.
Sorry about this.
I was like dunking on
okay.
it. Okay.
3, 2, 1, and lift. It's already. Is it sagging already? Can you
Mine
see it?
Mine isn't. It's just the chocolate is like.
Okay. It's everywhere.
Are we doing double dunk?
Yes. 1, 2, 3.
I'm traumatized from the last one. Oh, I made it!
Yep.
I made it.
Triple.
What?
1, 2.
You didn't tell me about this.
3. Now it's going.
Mine still isn't.
Mine's soft and. Right, I'm going for it. It's going in.
Okay. Oh. I just really like hot chocolate.
Mm hmm. Coffee.
Sorry we're so quiet. Mm-hmm. It's quite enjoyable, really.
If anything, they'll appreciate the fact that we shut up for once. Go on, what were you
thinking? So you can listen to our chewing noises. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Lovely. I like it. I like it as per use. I like it better with the dunk than before the dunk. He went for the... You went for a quadruple dunk yesterday.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
impressive.
So what are you saying? In terms of dunkability, it's a 7 because it didn't make it. It was
good.
It wouldn't have made it to a triple. But what about the post-dunk taste? You say it was made it worse.
No, better. So 7.5?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to go for 7.25.
Go for it. Be extra picky today.
I've never done that before. No, we can't.
Very
do.
Nice.
We can't do that. 7.3
then. Yeah, that's fine.
Satisfaction.
It's a solid.
Throw science to the wind as we have since we arrived here today. This
6.9.
Wow, that's very good. That was so quick. Moorishness, you can put that down now if you wish.
just to show you. I'm very sorry. I will wash my hands thoroughly. Yeah, I'm having a party in my head right now because I passed the dunk test because last time I failed and you all were so disappointed in me and it hurt my feelings. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah. Moorishness.
Great. I don't know whether
I think we're done. I think Ed's
but
done.
It's like it's a very disappointing because it is a nice biscuit, clearly.
It's a nice biscuit.
It just clearly needs to be left in a refrigerated area.
In a certain environment. Yeah. It will be in the polar regions, this will be a wonderful biscuit
Oh, yeah, definitely, wouldn't it, in the polar regions?
Yeah. Polar bears and penguins.
50.4 is still not bad. It's not great. It's not 68.
I'm not doing math again.
No, don't worry about the math.
Maths.
Maths.
Sorry.
50.4
there
puts
we go.
It in 60th place, 61st place out of...
Then it goes 59, right? Because name is one.
No, 61st because name is one.
Yeah, there you go. See? Don't. I can't.
Somebody is worse than me.
I'm horrible. Amazing. I can't do it.
All right.
It's quite an accomplishment.
Ah, God. What? Okay.
Yeah.
So.
Want to watch my...
Yeah, let's.
No, it's all good. It's all good. No, that was good. It withstood the tests of the dunk.
I think. I think that would have done better. Hmm. I mean, it was the durability, wasn't it?
In
that
winter.
It was
so
overall
if you wait two
good.
More weeks, it will be winter in the UK.
Excuse me.
Wow.
Sorry. It's
okay, burps are fine.
All right.
Can you burp on command?
No. Can you?
I can.
Really?
Yeah, I can. It's not
big. And we'll leave that for another screw for next week.
Next time, burps with Bo.
There you go.
Oh no, this will not be my thing.
No. All right. So, everybody, thank you very much for being here today. Yes. You've been absolutely incredible as usual.
Thanks for keeping us company during our...
Yeah. No, I think it was...
I was fine.
Excuse me. We're still on the way up.
Yes. Can only go up.
So it can only keep... Well, it can only just get... It's going to just make it more difficult when it does finally go down. It's going to be really terrible.
Which is never.
Never, because we're going to be on the rise.
Never, ever. Yes.
Biscuits with bow. Does make sense.
Biscuits with bow is good.
It does make sense.
Borps? No.
Borps. Brilliant.
Ed Bow.
Cheers, everybody.
Ed Bow
and Bow.
Yeah.
Will you come back again?
Will you have me?
Yeah, absolutely, 100%.
I will keep coming back. It's
what we just happened
fun.
Now. Okay, well, shouldn't this is? It is like there's been a war. There's biscuits everywhere. Chocolate.
Oh, look at that though. Oh.
It's
on my nose
it's
too.
It's getting worse. All right, everyone. We'll see you. I'll see you tomorrow for
chocolate
another guest
everywhere.
Wednesday.
Bye.
Thanks, bro.